Hi, I'm Michelle Sterling for Friends of Science Society. David Suzuki Foundation thinks that for reconciliation, we should all be planting forests. By contrast, Melissa Mbarki and many other Indigenous leaders think that Indigenous people should be involved in resource and energy development. But as Melissa pointed out in a recent article, it's going to be impossible for them to do that because of the crazy climate policies that the government is instituting, which at the same time they're instituting them, they actually violate the UN Declaration of Rights of Indigenous Peoples. Now, on June 23rd, 2023, the Justice Department released its action plan for incorporating UNDRIP in all laws in Canada. So all the laws in Canada are proposed to be aligned with UNDRIP, which means that all activities will be Indigenous-led. So how can the government be promoting UNDRIP on the one hand and First Nations rights and authorities, and on the other hand imposing climate policies that would make it impossible for Indigenous people to develop energy and mineral resources and do what they really want to do? They want to end poverty on reserve. So these are very complex issues, and I think we have two parallel tracks in Canada where mainstream Canada, shall we say, is not at all cognizant of these impending changes. And Indigenous Canada is very hopeful on the one hand, either of a huge carbon trading market that will give them a windfall of income simply by keeping the land static, not touching it, and then they will be paid in carbon credits, or the other people who are Indigenous people who are interested in actually working and being part of the mainstream society, developing energy and resources. So, you know, they're very complex issues, and I think that we need to have a look at both sides of them. I think we have to remember also, there was recently an article in the Hill Times where a couple of Cape doctors, that's the Canadian Association of Physicians for the Environment, were kind of sniping at Indigenous groups that are proponents of liquefied natural gas. Now that's mostly happening in BC, and they're trying to build gas pipelines to the coast so that that product can be exported. So they're saying, well, you know, these groups are not really grassroots Indigenous people. They are an industry proxy. Well, guess what? CAPE was funded for about $400,000 in 2022 to engage in a climate plan, and since then they've been doing nothing but bashing natural gas. And their funder was the McConnell Foundation, which in 2017 committed $10 million to a BlackRock Global Fund 2 for renewables. So you see, there's a conflict of interest there, in my opinion. And to me, it looks like CAPE is actually the proxy for a renewables industry investor. And they're just kind of the pot calling the kettle black. Anyway, it's a very important development in Canada's economy. And people should definitely be paying much more attention to it than they are. So remember, the United Nations Declaration of Rights for Indigenous People, the Justice Department Action Plan, the statements by the CAPE doctors that are in the Hill Times, and the statements by Melissa Mbarki and other Indigenous groups like the National Coalition of Chiefs. They're trying to end poverty on reserve. And like the LNG Alliance out in British Columbia, again, which is trying to develop jobs and the economy for Indigenous people and get them a step forward, a hand up, not a handout. Think about it. Look at the materials. Talk about it. For Friends of Science Society, I'm Michelle Sterling.